Hello everyone, welcome to the module 4 of digital system design. This module 4 discusses about the sequential circuit design, and also it discusses about the sequential networks, wherein we'll see the Mealy and Moore sequential networks. Okay, so let us start with the module 4 with sequential circuit design. Anyway, this is a little bit of continuation of the module 3. And at the end of the module 3, we had discussed about design of a ripple binary counter, or what we call it as an asynchronous counter. Okay, but in this module 4, that too in the first part, we'll try to see a design of synchronous counters. Okay, so that will be the first part, and the second part we'll see the sequential networks, about both the Mealy and the Moore sequential networks, and what are those, and also some examples on that. Okay, so this is what we'll try to do now. And now, whenever we design a synchronous counter, okay, rather than the asynchronous counter, we are very much interested in knowing what is this excitation table is all about. Okay, so we have to have the excitation table when we try to design the synchronous counter. And excitation table are, we have excitation tables for SR flip-flop, for D, JK, as well as on. So four different types of flip-flops are there. We are having the excitation tables for all. Okay, so how we are getting this excitation table, let's look into that. Okay, so here we'll try to get the excitation table, or we derive kind of excitation table for a JK flip-flop. Okay, so and that's what we'll try to see now. Okay, so we'll try to design the excitation table for JK flip-flop. Okay, that's what we'll have. So in order to have an excitation table, okay, first you have to start with the characteristic table, or what we call it as a truth table. Okay, and by this time I think everyone knows what exactly a truth table is all about. Okay, the, when I say a truth table of JK flip-flop, it tells that for given input and the previous output, what is its next state output. Okay, that's what we'll have. Okay, so for us, previous output I call it as something like Qn, and the next state output will be Qn plus 1. And most of these flip-flops are with respect to the edge triggered, okay, or pulse triggered. I can use both pulse as well as edge triggered. Okay, so we know the truth table of JK flip-flop, wherein it says, provided the clock, that means whenever the flip-flop is enabled, if J and K values are 0, 0, then it's next state output will be the previous. If it is 0, 1, that is J0K1, it is reset. When J1K0, it is set. And when both J and K are 1, 1, my output will be complement of previous. Okay. And to see the extended version of this characteristic table, okay, we'll try to include Qn also as one of the input. And we know that a sequential circuit is nothing but what? Sequential circuit is that, is the logical circuit or a digital circuit in which output depends upon its input as well as on its previous output. Okay, this is previous output. Okay, so now we'll try to define this truth table in terms of state table in an elaborative way. Okay, and we also, and this we are trying to develop using truth table. So for the very first combination of JK, both 0, 0, my output will be previous. And in this case, what is previous? 0. That's why I made it as 0. When J0K1, output is simply reset. This is a reset. Okay? 0. That is clear. Irrespective of what is my previous. Don't think that this 0 is following this. No. Okay? When J1K0, it will set. That is what we mean by yes. When J and K both 1, 1, my output will be complement of previous. What is previous in this case? It is 0. That's why it is 1. Okay. This is Qn. This is Qn bar. Again, if I just bifurcate this into two halves, in the first half, Qn is 0, and in the next half, Qn is 1. Okay. But you can see J and K again repeating from 0, 0 to 1, 1. 0, 0, this is previous, and previous in this case is 1. 0, 1, it is reset. 1, 0, it is set. That is what. And 1, 1, it is the complement of previous. Previous is 1, that's why it is 0. This is the elaborative truth table. And now, What we can see now it is I want this elaborated characteristic table, or what we call it as a state table, in order to get this excitation table. That's what. Okay, so the major requirement to get the excitation table is the truth table or the characteristic table. Yes. So now we are interested in, this is a state table which tells us if I know the previous output and the input, I can get what is the output. Okay, but now I will look into these two columns, that is the Q1 and Qn plus one. So for current understanding, I call this as if this is my present state, this will be next state, previous state. If this is presented, this is the next state. Okay, so that's what I'll try to do this now. Just erase this. Escape. Just close this and once again get my annotation there. Yeah, so if this I consider it as present state, if this is present and this will be my next state, that is the meaning. Okay, there is no other way. If this is present, this will be previous state. Okay, so I can define in any ways, but now right now I want Qn to be present state and this is my next state. Okay, now in this particular table, I have present state, I have next state, and also input. So now what we'll try to do now is, truth table gives us the output for the corresponding input and the previous, right? Now, using the truth table, extended truth table, we're trying to get the excitation table. What exactly excitation table is all about? If I know the present state and the next state, I can get the values of J and K, and that is what is very important. Okay, that's what. So now in the excitation table, I am considering the present state as the first column, next state as the another column. Okay, so this is my present state and this is my next state. And I know that present state Qn, next state Qn plus one, only two variables, I will have four set of combination. Okay, now if I see this present state and the next state, okay, present state is zero in the first row, next state is zero. Similarly, second row, present state is zero, next state is zero. Okay, that means the first two rows of this table gives me the same value of Qn and the same value of Qn plus one. Okay, these two I mean by. Okay, that means Qn is zero, Qn plus one is also zero. That means present state zero, next state zero. What is happening to my J and K for these corresponding values of Qn and Qn plus one? Okay, you can see that for the first two rows wherein Qn and Qn plus one are remaining 0, 0. Okay, what is the Jn? Jn is also remaining 0, so that's why I have made Jn to be 0. But what is Kn? Neither it is 0 nor it is remaining 1, that's why it is don't care. Either D you can take, or in some of the other textbook you can see even this don't care also. Okay, that's one. Next, present state 0, next state 1. Present state 0, next state 1. Present state 0, next state 1. Again, for the next two rows, my present state is 0 and the next state is becoming 1. Okay, again, these two rows are same for me, for which J is remaining 1. That is why I made this as 1. Whereas D, neither it is remaining in 0 nor it is remaining in 1. That's why it is don't care. That means it is D, or sometimes we call it as X also, which is don't care, right? And now, then the next particular present and the next state, Qn and Qn plus 1 value, 1, 0. Okay, 1, 0. Whereas 1, this is 1, the next state is 0. And again, this is 1 and the next state is 0. Okay, you can see there, right? So for this two particular row, my Qn is 1 and Qn plus 1 is 0. We can see that my Jn is 0 in one case, 1 is in other case, whereas Kn is remaining 1. Yes, this is what. So that's why my Jn is don't care, whereas Kn is remaining 1 only. Yes. And we'll come to the last one, that is present state is 1, next state is also 1. Present state is 1, next state is also 1. That means for the fifth and the seventh row, again Jn is varying with respect to 0, 1, whereas Kn is fixed, that is 0, 0. That means J is varying, that's why it is don't care, whereas K is not varying, it is 0, that's why it is 0. And now you can see that for a JK flip-flop, if I know the stage, that is the present state and the next state, 0, 0, it is 0, don't care. If it is 0, 1, it is 1, don't care. If it is 1, 0, then it is don't care 1. And if it is 1, 1, it is don't care 0. Okay, this is very, very important now when we are designing a synchronous counter. So the prerequisite for designing a synchronous counter is we need to have, or we need to know the excitation tables of all the flip-flops. It may be a JK, that is depending upon using which flip-flop we are trying to design the counter. And how we get the excitation table? From the extended truth table, we get the excitation table. Okay, so that's what. So having knowing how to get the excitation table, now we'll go and discuss about designing a synchronous counter.